Hey there, friends. So I am currently in Boston, Massachusetts for, I taught workshops a couple days ago, and now I am heading down to Powderhead Square to record a Drex Challenge combo. But I've been thinking a lot lately about both the past and the future of the Flow Festival circuit, and I wanted to share some of those thoughts with you. So, hey, you want to come walk with me? Drex here from DrexFactory.com, and today we are talking about one of the most venerable traditions in the flow arts, namely the festivals. But how long are they going to stick around for? So before we dive in, I just want to give a shout out to the friends of the channel. Big thanks to Dark Monk, Flow Toys, LMF Props, Spinballs, and Ultrapoi for helping make videos on this channel possible. And of course, you can learn more about all these awesome companies by checking out the links that I've got down in the description of this video. So I've been attending Flow Festivals now for 10 years, 10 years plus, I think. My first one was Fire Drums in 2009. And then as now, one of the greatest parts of the Flow Festivals, for me at least, is the ability to connect with other people and to be able to expand my horizons inside the community, to be able to learn new things, get introduced to new ideas, and, you know, try out new props and things like that. So far as I can tell, the first festival that we would truly call a modern-day fire festival was Fire Drums. It started up in the early aughts. Very soon after that, Chad Bennett, a gentleman from Boston, visited Fire Drums and decided to start his own version of it that he called Wildfire, which has been going on now for the greater part of 10 years as well. Now, the thing is that, like, originally there were only a few fire festivals in the country, but the number grew, and it grew very, very rapidly. The first year I decided to track all of the fire festivals on my website would have been, 2014, maybe 15. And that year, I kid you not, I counted at least 50 festivals that were being held in the United States. It was one of those things that you basically almost every week could attend an event. And in fact, many times you'd be in a situation where there would be multiple events in a single weekend. Now, clearly, most of these events did not stick around, but there have definitely been some that have been reliable events. You know, the FAI events, Wildfire, of course, continues to have multiple times a year, and Cassandra Tannenbaum's Flow Fests continues to have events in multiple cities. But aside from that, you know, the advent of the independent festival has been kind of a mixed bag. So in the past few years, we have dropped from having 50 festivals a year to half that many of that. And it opens up the big question of why on earth is that? What happened? Like, why did we go from so many to so few? And is there any chance we can go back to the numbers that we used to have? Well, I'm not so sure. So there's an interesting thing that I kind of suspected and built a little bit of data for over the years. You see, back when we used to have 40, 50 events a year, I remember going around to all of them and being struck by one really, really, really interesting fact. That is, whenever I go to one of these events, it'd be the same faces that I'd see at all the other events, you know? Same group of friends, same bunch of people, just the environment was different, right? And I suspected that what was going on was that the attendance at a lot of these events was being bolstered by people that were buying tickets to like 10 separate events, rather than only going to the event that was closest to them.
What's up, YouTube? How's it going?
Good, how are you? That was interesting. And I've managed to somewhat confirm this suspicion. I help run Flame Festival, and every year we put out a feedback form to people and ask them a number of questions about both why they came to the event as well as their attendance to other FAI events. And what we found is that in the past 2 years, the number of people that have attended more than one FAI event has dropped by 40%. That's a really big number. So you can easily see how this might create a problem, right? Because if we have the same group of people that are basically responsible for making ticket sales happen for multiple events, unless we can make sure that we've got new blood coming in that's willing to do the same thing, those events are going to have a hard time maintaining their attendance. And that's pretty much exactly what the statistics seem to bear out. Namely, that people are less likely to buy tickets to multiple events, and people are less likely to buy tickets to even their home event anymore. So why would that be? So, I mean, I think it's helpful to talk about what the festivals are doing right. And I mean, the thing that really all of us want out of those festivals is an opportunity to hang out and spend time in an immersive environment with other people who share our same interests. And they still do a great job of that. You still get to go hang out with your friends and meet people that you've seen on the internet and spin in the fire circle to some awesome DJs, right? These things are all very, very core things that we look forward to and that still make the Fire Festival special. But let's face it, there's also a negative side. Part of that is that the quality of instruction that you get at Fire Festivals usually isn't that terribly good. Another part of it, you know, in a lot of cases, people who are coming into the flow in fire arts right now are coming from the rave scene, so they have a very, very, very close relationship with the music they listen to. And more often than not, at fire festivals, we call the music lineups out of people that are in the fire community itself. So these might not necessarily be the people that attendees are most excited to listen to. There's also the issue that these are really, more often than not, a la carte experiences. What do I mean by that? Well, you're responsible for camping and for making all of your food happen, etc. And it tends to be that you get through the weekend not eating enough, not drinking enough, and not sleeping enough. So I don't know about you guys, but I almost always find that when I come out of an event like that, I'm feeling more exhausted than energized. And when it comes to thinking about which events I want to attend, that definitely becomes a calculus in the future. All right, so I have reached my destination and I'm gonna sit down and record a Drex Challenge combo right quick, which if you guys are not already following me on Instagram, you should do that because I post one of these combos every Thursday for the people on my Instagram to learn, and then they can post their own version of it to their own Instagram. So it's a pretty cool way that I get to teach people on that platform. So let me get to that. I'll be right back. All right, mission accomplished, and now I'm officially running late, so I gotta hightail it back to the house. And of course, there is one other 800-pound gorilla in the room where we talk about some of the ways in which the fire festivals are falling short. And that is the fact that as many of us get older, a lot of us are also having families. And I don't know about you, but the environment that you have at most of the fire festivals, I don't think I'd be comfortable bringing a kid there, would you? Okay, so we've talked about where the fire festivals have come from. We have talked about where they might be having some deficiencies. So the question becomes, do the fire festivals have a future? And if so, what is it? So my short answer to this is yes, the fire festivals have a future. And there's going to be two provisos there, because one of two things is probably going to happen there. It's either that the fire festivals are going to kind of atrophy down and become less of a force overall, that there will always be just a couple fire festivals every year that you can attend if you want to, but that by and large we'll never get back to a place where there's like 50 of them running a year and all of them are getting multiple hundreds of attendees. I remember one year at Fire Drums when there were 1,200 people there, and to be honest with you, I don't think that's ever going to happen again. Now, the other possibility is that we have a radical reimagining of what the fire festivals are, and then that can become the next evolution of them. Here's the trick, though. We as a community are not stellar at evolving. We have this tendency to find something that makes us very comfortable and to not want to move outside of that comfort zone for anything. I'm also going to say that as a whole, we are working against a very, very, very big deficit. Namely, the fact that live entertainment, that is live events that people go and attend and everything, by and large isn't doing that well either. You know, we're at a place where even the music festivals seem to have plateaued in attendance. They're not growing anymore, at least not exponentially. And everything from live theater to live music to, you know, live dance and everything, even circus is having a really hard time putting butts in seats. We have this weird problem that we're working against, that culture is shifting away from environments in which people come to experience something and schedule their time around it. We're existing in a time where people are used to getting content on demand, where they're used to the things that they want coming to them when they want them to come to them. But there are exceptions. There are live events that people do make the time to go out and see. In particular, the whole idea of like pop-up museums and everything is doing gangbusters right now, partially because they're experiences that people get to share via social media, and that takes care of a lot of the marketing for it. People want to have that experience of being there. So the question becomes, can we integrate some of that into how the fire festivals work? can we, say, create interactive experiences that don't just exist over the course of one weekend, but are things that people can come experience over the course of several weeks? And that way, you can drum up a little bit of publicity for them and get people more interested in coming. Once they begin to see how they can interact with those experiences, that then becomes more of an incentive for them to take the chance to come out and do it. I think we also need to accept at this point, too, that we're dealing with a different crowd of people than when the fire festivals first emerged. Like, I can remember when they first started up, and the fire scene was really kind of a derivative. It was an offshoot of, like, the Burning Man scene. And that is definitely no longer the case. I was really shocked the first time there was a festival that was scheduled across from Burning Man. I thought that they would have no attendees, and in fact, their attendance was great. That was the first signal that I had that the culture was shifting and it was no longer based around burners. And for good or for ill, that also means that we have to anticipate the fact that people who are in the fire spinning culture now more likely are people that didn't necessarily learn about it from going to Burning Man, but almost certainly learned about it from going to EDM events, raves, etc. And they have a slightly different set of values. They have a slightly different set of things that they look for in terms of going to an event. And whether we like it or not, if that is the primary group of people that are coming into the art, we have to cater to that. We have to find out what it is they're looking for in an event and be able to provide it. And finally, I think that we're just going to need to learn how to take better care of our people. It's one thing to bring in a whole bunch of new people, ravers or wherever else people happen to come from, and it's another to be able to hold on to them. Because half of our problem here is that people are aging out and no longer buying tickets to multiple events and everything. Which, to be frank, I think that we don't get to dial back the clock on that one. I think that that is just the world that we're living in right now. But in terms of holding on to people for longer, we have to make it easier for people to bring their families out to these events and have it be something they can experience together. If for no other reason than as an event manager, this should be easy math. If you get a family to come out there, you're not just selling one ticket, you're selling like three or four tickets. So I know one of the challenges that we have overall is that we really want to believe that everything is awesome all the time. And I think that in a lot of cases, that leads us to holding on to things that are no longer serving us for far too long. And we're going to see that in its biggest case with how the Flow Festivals turn out. Again, I don't think the Flow Festivals will ever completely go away, but I also anticipate a point in my lifetime when there's only like three or four of them left in the country, and they more exist as something that is part of nostalgia, people who just never move on from that part of the culture. And, you know, that's fine, that can happen. But man, what if we could put together events for a new generation of spinners? Wouldn't that be something? So now I'm really curious. Have you guys attended an event in the past year? How many events have you attended? And what did you find great about those events? And what did you wish they had done better? Let me know down in the comments. I really want to find out from you guys what it is that you're looking for in these experiences and how the festivals can market to you and create an experience that is going to be important to you. And I'd also like to take a minute to just thank all of my awesome supporters on Patreon, because they are the reason that this video and all the videos on this channel exist. If you would like to sign up to support the work that I do, please head on over to patreon.com/drexfactorpoi and sign up. Thank you in advance.